headed to watch a little football practice, I think. Welcome to beautiful Stark Vegas. This is where KJ Costello is going to be your starting quarterback here in 2020 for your Mississippi State Bulldogs.
Has he ever come up to you and said, KJ, you're my starter for the opening week?
Oh, he hasn't done that yet. I mean, his MO is competition, competition, competition.
For the first time in this preseason, they have made the quarterbacks, KJ Costello, and your new backup quarterback, Will Rogers, the freshman from Brandon, they made him available to the media. They talked.
From day one, the effort and attitude of this team is something that's inspired me, and I've respected as well. I've definitely seen coming to the SEC, you know, the slogan they always say, it means more. I've seen it just in the day-to-day practice. I mean, 7-on-7 dudes, you know, damn near going live, which is awesome to see. Guys are battling for roles on the team, fighting for starting spots. So I've really highlighted the idea of, you know, me wanting to be a catalyst, elevating the guys around me, making sure that I know my job through and through. You know, I haven't been in this system for 4 years. So I'm putting a big emphasis on making sure I do my job before demanding everything out of everybody else. But I think as a whole, everyone's starting to kind of come into their own and kind of understand their roles and know where they're supposed to be on the field in this offense, in the scheme.
Costello, very accurate, very sharp, very on time, throws a really soft, catchable football when he needs to and can pipe it in there when he has to.
Before we ever really stepped foot on field, I felt like I knew all of the concepts on paper. So from walkthroughs, I don't know, I'm in camp right now, but that started, I don't know, maybe a month and a half, 2 months ago. It's been putting what I know on paper into real life. And, you know, the plays, what a lot of people don't understand about this offense, and I've seen so much tape from Washington State, is one play can play out, you know, 3 to 6 different ways. So making sure that my eyes are in the right place and I'm kind of sensing what's going to happen before it's happened.
Rogers ran this offense in high school, and at Brandon High School had a lot of success and came in just ahead. Will Rogers is a guy who is probably has the best mechanics throwing a football of all the quarterbacks they've had out here.
Yeah, I'm extremely comfortable in this offense. You know, we did the same thing in high school. It was very similar. You know, a lot of the same plays, things like that. It was just called different stuff. So, you know, when I'm out there with those guys, I'm just trying to score every possession, score every drive, and I'm extremely comfortable in the offense.
There's got to be something special about a true freshman to unseat a guy who was your starter last year, move him to wide receiver because of his ability, that Schrader. Rogers has a chance to be really, really good here in this offense.
Yeah, you know, Garrett's great. You know, he's a big target, big athletic guy. He can really run. And, yeah, actually his first day receiver, we actually connected on a long touchdown pass. So that was pretty cool, you know, and it just showed Garrett's upside and what he can do with the ball in his hands.
He reminds me a lot of myself, not to pat myself on the back, but me coming in as a freshman, you know, just really eager to play, you know, really eager to get reps, not gun shy. You know, he's willing to fail, which a lot of times freshmen are kind of timid at times. I think we really molded our relationship when we kind of looked at each other when we were here in June, July, and like, hey, I mean, we got a month and a half. Let's team up and teach this offense to the guys. You know, we're not really trying to compete. I mean, we're competing, but at the same time, like, it was on our shoulders to – he had ran a little bit of the system in high school. You know, I had to absorb a totally new system. And we were kind of leaning on each other's shoulders to communicate effectively to everybody else what they were doing. And, you know, not a lot of people will probably mention that, but I think that's going to pay dividends this year in terms of how we were effectively able to know the whole offense. I mean, if you came out to the first to three practices, most of the guys knew everything they were doing.
All right. Hope you enjoy that from here in Stark Vegas. Good content?
Good content.
See you on the next one. See you.